If you're interviewing for a product manager role at a top tech company, you're most likely going to be asked a question like, how would you set products for fill in the blank? In my past video, I covered a framework to help you tackle these questions, and it ended up being one of my most popular videos. And to follow up with that, I then shared another video giving a couple of examples using this framework to come up with metrics for top Facebook products. So today, we're gonna talk about two more of Facebook's products that I'm gonna walk you through and use a framework to come up with success metrics and goals. Hey guys, I'm Diana and I'm a senior product manager at a big tech company in Silicon Valley, California. And I bring you the best tips to get into product management and teach you how to succeed once you've made it. So to remind you guys of the framework. So first, we're gonna start off with understanding what the product is, who are the users, and what is the value to them. Number two, we're gonna come up with a North Star metric that's gonna be the intersection of value between the users and stakeholders. Three, we're gonna break down that North Star to come up with some health metrics that represent a healthy ecosystem. And number four, we're gonna talk about downstream effects that this product will have in the larger Facebook ecosystem and some counter metrics. So what is the events product? The product connects hosts who are organizing events with people looking to attend events. So how does it work? A host will start off by creating an event page where they add details about where the event is happening, what the event is about. Then they can invite people or make it a public event where anyone who discovers it can join. People who look at the event page can RSVP to go or interact on the event page by commenting, asking questions. Now let's talk about the values for each of the users we talked about. On one side, it's the hosts, and they get value when people actually attend their events. On the other side are attendees, and they find value when they discover events or get invited to events and when they attend the event. And for Facebook, they get value when people are interacting either before the event happens, during the event, and then after the event, when people are connecting to become friends. So in our second step, we're looking for the North Star. A good North Star is at the intersection of value between these various parties. So the common denominator here seems to be when people are attending the actual event. For events, when attendance is offline, it's harder for Facebook to measure whether someone actually attended the event or not. So I'm thinking, what is a good proxy metric to represent event attendance? And here I might count the number of people who RSVP to at least one event in the last week. Some others might call out total RSVP to events. But why I chose my former metric is I'd prefer to know that this product is being used broadly across multiple people because total RSVPs for events could bias toward the power users. If the interviewer finds it interesting, you can also talk about how to more accurately measure event attendance. All right, my third step, I'm gonna break down the North Star. For a healthy events ecosystem, there has to be enough healthy supply of events. So I would measure the number of active events per day. And I might segment by public versus private events, online versus offline events, just to understand what that makeup is like. A key advantage we can have on Facebook versus other events platforms like Eventbrite is to have the most number of events available to people, which help us stay competitive, but also a good distribution of types of events to keep people engaged. A second metric we can measure is the number of hosts per day. Hosts are the foundation of the product. If they stop organizing, which organizing, come on, it's not an easy job, then the product isn't gonna be that valuable. So we need to keep a healthy number of hosts on the platform continually organizing events. Now let's move to the attendee side of the ecosystem. If we're thinking about the funnel, I first wanna know there's a healthy number of people who visit the events tab. We want people regularly coming to the events product to discover new events and to be the key product they use to plan every weekend. I might also wanna measure the average click-through rate of event to give me an idea how relevant are these events to most people and make sure I don't fall under a certain threshold. I might also want to count the number of people who are interacting in the events page. There are comments, posts, shares, reactions, because this is meaningful interactions happening on the events page. And something else I want to measure is the average number of RSVPs per person per month. We want to facilitate people attending more events over time because they either had a good experience from the last event that they found on Facebook, because the more events people attend, the more friends people make, and the more friends people make, the more useful the Facebook ecosystem is for them to stay up to date with their friends. Now, what are some downstream impacts of the events product? So positive impacts could be the number of incremental friend connections happening because of events, because we expect when people go to events and meet new people, they're gonna make new friends. I'd also wanna measure the number of incremental posts coming from events. At events, we're taking photos, so naturally we would wanna post that onto our timeline. And when we're planning to attend events, people are messaging each other either before, during, or after. So we also want to measure the number of incremental conversations happening from events. Have you learned something new in the last couple of minutes? If so, let us know by liking the video. And next week, I'm coming up with a new video to help you ace the product manager interview. So make sure you don't miss it and subscribe to the channel now.